Okay, hi everyone. Welcome at this third video in the Crowd Expedition weekly update. Martijn, how was your week?
Good.
So this is the end of it. I told you we are going to really try to be shorter than last time. First one 30 minutes, second 20 minutes. So Kelly, our camera lady, I'm really going to try to stick within the 10 minutes.
Yes, we do.
But tell me, how was your week? What have you done?
Yeah, it was a good week. We just had to rest a little bit from our We Share Fest adventure from previous week. And this week we had one interview yesterday.
Barkfly Rent, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right. They're based in at Schiphol Airport. It's a really nice concept. They're just really in the startup phase. They're now open for about 2 months. And what they say, okay, the founder Niels had a really two bad travel experiences, because when he was going to on holidays, first you had to park your car at the airport. It's really expensive, especially when you are at the expensive part. You will pay about 150 euro for 2 weeks. So he said, okay, parking is more expensive than my ticket. And the other part, so when you arrive at your destination, then you have to go to the car rental desk, and there they treat you like shit. So he said, okay, I want to think about something to change that. So now he founded Carfly Rent. The concept is, you have your car, you park them at their parking space, they will bring you to the gate where you depart. When you are away on holidays, they will rent your car to other people. And when you arrive back, you will get your car, it's all cleaned. And when it's rented during your holiday, you also get some money. And you don't have any cost on parking.
Sounds great. Yeah. You talked about it more in the first video we did. So if you want to know more about the concept of Carfly Rent, go to their website or check the first video of the Crowd Expedition weekly update. You are looking for the collaborative economy. How do you relate that, the collaborative economy, to Carfly Rent?
The collaborative economy is also about how you can use how you can make more sustainable use of the products you have. So like with a car sharing platform, you are sharing your car while it's normally standing still. Yeah. And that's the same also, so it's making more better, making more effective use of the resources available. So like with Parkfly Rent, it's crazy that at one way in at the airport we have thousands of cars standing still while people are traveling. At the other side, we have thousands of cars waiting from the car rental companies for somebody who wants to rent it. So there's a disconnection between demand and supply. And I think the collaborative economy is really also about making the right connection between this demand and supply.
Yeah, and this founder, his name is Niels, right?
Yeah.
Any idea where Niels got the inspiration for this new concept?
I think, and that's most the most times when people have inspiration for innovation, most of the innovation comes from frustration, that you have an experience and you think, why? And with in his case, it was during his own holiday.
Okay, because a couple of weeks ago, there was this program on the Netherlands that people who were parking their car at unofficial parking lots nearby Schiphol, the main airport in the Netherlands, that when they came back, the car was indeed cleaned, but there was also a higher amount of kilometers, a substantial higher amount, like 2,000 kilometers extra on their dashboard. So somebody used their car. And the program was about the fact that they were unofficially renting the car to people who were coming to the Netherlands. Or they were using the car for all, but it's not that was the reason for his inspiration. So
no,
why
no.
Don't we do that, but then officially?
No. But they are doing it officially. So because they're also saying we are a car rental company, but we are don't own our own cars, but we are using cars from people who are traveling around the world.
Okay. Is he going to expand?
Yeah.
In other countries or?
Yes, and this year or next year they're going to expand to the first country.
Which one? Any idea?
No, they're not saying, but I think Germany or the UK. They didn't say anything about it, but I guess this will be one of those two.
Okay.
And when they are going to enter a new country, they are going to enter at 5 main airports in one time, because they really need the skill also to grow their business.
Okay. Any insights you want to share with the people watching about this this company, this expedition, this learning experience of Niels in his company?
Mm-hmm. I think he also gave some off-the-record examples of how the existing companies are through political shit are trying to block his growth.
Why?
Because they see him as a threat.
Okay.
Because when you look at the traditional car renting market, almost 90% is dominated by four big companies.
Yeah.
So they got a lot to lose.
Yeah.
And so they really see new initiatives as a threat. And that's also a big learning for existing companies, because the fact that there is a new company in your market means that you are not using all possible possibilities.
Mm.
So when you focus at what are they doing and how can we also take advantage of that, that's a much better way to conquer your new market parties than when you're going to do it yourself.
Okay, so that's one. You had more?
Yeah, there was also a nice question from Sebastian Hoofd, one of our expert team members. He said, okay.
He's in the expert team,
yeah,
Sebastian.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Nice. From Central.
Yeah, he found Central Point, but now he's a VC and also
Kickstart, isn't it, or Rockstart? He's a
mentor. Yes,
mentor,
yeah,
at
also,
Rockstart.
Yeah, doing lots of nice entrepreneurial things.
Yeah.
So he's also from his entrepreneurial expertise a member of the team.
Yeah, great guy.
And yes, definitely. And he asked, okay, I always get nervous when salespeople are starting tech startups. And so he also asked, okay, do we also have tech people in your board? And then Niels said, okay, no, because we don't see ourselves as a tech startup, but we see ourselves as a hospitality startup. Mm. And that's also the big difference they have in their competition with the other car rental companies. They're really focusing on hospitality and not on the tech part. And that's also a nice decision when you have to, when you're going to start a new startup, about, okay, which people are you going to involve in your team? Because like with Pascal Snapcar, he said, okay,
exactly.
I'm never going to do another startup without a tech guy in the board.
Yeah, it really resonates with what you mentioned last week.
Yeah, that's right. So it's, I think time will tell. And I think, because I think when we have asked Pascal in the start phase of Snapcar the same question, he probably would have said,
I'm not a tech company.
Yeah. So I'm really curious about the way you're looking at Parc Florent in let's say 5 years. They want to be the market leader in 5 years in Europe. That's their ambition. So I'm really looking forward to talking to him and then again, and then ask him again, okay, are you a tech company or are you a hospitality company? But I think he made a good point, because the tech part is a part of their whole concept.
Yeah, but quite essential.
Yeah, but in the end, with Snapcar, they're really, with the platform, they're connecting users, two people directly to each other.
Yeah.
And with Parc Florent, it's a peer-to-business-to-peer company.
Yeah,
so
I understand.
So it's a complete, so they're more like a traditional car renting company, but then they're not owning their own cars. Then like with Snapcar, who is connecting peer-to-peer the people directly to each other.
Okay, so that was past week. To summarize, it was a bit easier. You had to relax from a very extremely busy week last week. You went to Parc Florent. Any other special things you did this week?
No. Okay. No, yeah, we're now also busy with the design of the videos together with our partner Imagine People to make a nice intro, outro, and some nice leaders for our names.
Okay, top.
So we're making some good.
So I'm getting this nice thingy. Wow, cool.
Yeah, jelly driver.
Looking forward to that, the jelly driver next week. Yeah. Okay, so then let's stop about this week. What's next week? What's your agenda for next week?
Three interviews, two live interviews and one Google Hangout interview.
Okay.
Interview with backseatsurfing.com, It's a hitchhike platform.
Okay.
Where you can say, okay, I'm looking for to travel with somebody in a car.
Another
from
one.
A to B.
Yeah. Aren't there already loads of platforms trying to connect hitchhikers?
There are loads of, but there are just a few who are successful. So we're going to see how successful they are.
Okay. And looking forward to. I'm very curious. Okay.
We're going to. Can You Bring? It's a company that uses people who are already traveling that can bring stuff that can transport stuff from people from A to B. So like when you're flying from Amsterdam to New York and somebody needs to have a package transported from Amsterdam to New York, then he can give his package to you without any interaction, of course.
Yeah, okay. Well, I can imagine that is one of the main concerns. Yeah. It was the first thing that pops up in my mind, and you mentioned it directly without any drugs. So
so that will also be one of the questions we're going to ask them.
Okay.
And last one, next Thursday, we're going to the Paleiskwartier. I don't know how to say it in English, in Den Bosch, in the Netherlands. They're having a electric car sharing program in a really close area. So we're going to talk to them.
Okay. What do you want to know from them? Specifically, is there a main question you're asking everyone?
No. Okay. Yes. Of course, about the vision on the Clarity of Economy and what they think about everything. But like with the Paleiskwartier, we're going to look. Okay, how? What is your experience with implementing a new thing in a existing environment? That's really important with the carpool back seat guru that come about okay, how are you dealing with trust, but also with a really specific question between okay, you got supply and demand, but also at a really specific time and place. How do you handle that? And with
a lot of questions. Okay, so the main question is how are you? What are your visions according to the collaborative economy?
And also your experience with implementing it into the real daily life.
Okay, well, I'm really looking forward to their answers. We are through the time, otherwise I'm getting a fight with Kelly again for going
again,
over the 20 minutes. Kelly, how many minutes are we now? 12.
So getting closer.
Next week we are getting close to 10.
Nine and a half next week.
One more thing. It's in my office, so I forgot to bring it here. We got a book. You got a book. I got one as well from Ine Nijland. It's written by Jan Jonker and some of his students, and it's about the weak economy. So I wanted to give it to you here. I'm going to give it to you later on.
Yeah, great.
So that's a gift from Jan and Ine.
Yeah, cool. Thank you.
Yeah. See you next week.
Next week.
Looking forward
to
it. Yeah. Welcome.
Okay.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.